new at 11, a rare look inside the vault storing pieces of space history. We're talking about the moon rocks and dust brought back to Earth during the first mission to the moon and beyond.
It sounds like Buzz Lightyear or something. But this vault looks like something out of a movie, maybe that one, but it's real life. News 6 anchor Eric Von Aken takes us on a road trip of sorts to show us this priceless collection.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
49 years ago,
that's one small step for man.
Americans landed on the moon.
One giant leap for mankind.
And what a leap it was. Apollo 11 astronauts Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin not only landed on the moon, they brought some of it back with them.
And you can see the stars and stripes on the lunar surface.
Rocks and moon dust.
The surface is fine and powdery.
Made it back to Earth. And most of them are stored here in Texas behind this giant vault door at the Johnson Space Center.
Each one of these cabinets is just storage for the different Apollo samples.
Between 1969 and 1972, astronauts on six Apollo missions brought back 842 pounds of lunar rocks, sand, and dust. It all started with that first landing.
This is the Apollo 11 cabinet. So all the samples that were brought back by the Apollo 11 mission are stored in this one cabinet.
The samples collected by Armstrong and Aldrin are all right here.
We're in the Apollo Sample Laboratory.
Ryan Ziegler is the curator of lunar samples.
And this is where most of the moon rocks on Earth are stored.
Ziegler makes sure that all of the samples are secure. In fact, it took two people just to unlock the vault, which is deep inside a high-security building. Nearly 400 samples are distributed each year for research and teaching. This is a small piece of the largest sample collected right at the end of Apollo 11 by Neil Armstrong. It became the most studied lunar sample on Earth.
When he looked at the rock box that was half full of samples, and he thought, I'm not bringing that back half empty. So he got a shovel, and he literally shoveled several shovelfuls of soil into the rock box and then sealed it up.
These international treasures are stored in a water and airtight vault 46 feet above sea level. And what we learn from large moon rocks and smaller samples of moon dust could help us learn more about the early history of the moon, the Earth, and our solar system.
Tranquility Base, Houston. Guidance recommendation is pings, and you're cleared for takeoff.
Since America is the only country to have put humans on the moon, officially the U.S. owns all moon rocks and moon dust. NASA, however, doesn't mind sharing. The agency says that they do loan samples to scientists around the world in the spirit of research. I'm Eric Von Aken, News 6.